Bismillah, Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala Rasulillah. Understand Quran and Salah the easy way, 3-minute series, lesson number 4A. By the end of this lesson, inshallah, we will learn 14 words which occur almost 5,200 times in the Quran. So let us start. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. The ayah for this lesson is Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. All the praises and thanks be to Allah, Lord of the worlds. Alhamdu is made up of two words. Al here means all. Hamd has two meanings, praise and thanks. Therefore, Alhamdu means all praises and thanks. By the way, Assalamu means all peace. Alaykum be upon you. Alhamdu, all praises and thanks. Lillahi be to Allah. Li means to. Lillahi to Allah. Rabb means the one who takes care of us and helps us grow. Al-alameen. Al means the. Alam means world. Alameen means worlds. Rabbil alameen, the Lord of the worlds, or the Rabb of the worlds. Allah is Rabbil alameen. If He doesn't take care of the sun, the moon, the earth, the gravity and so on, the whole world will collapse and we will die in a fraction of a second. So imagine the world of humans, the world of angels, of jinns, of galaxies, and Allah knows what else. He is taking care of all of these simultaneously. Shouldn't our heart be filled with His praise when we say Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen? So habit number 3 is always be a student of different types of knowledge so that you can feel Allah's greatness and praise Allah from the depth of your heart. Another meaning of hamd is thanks. Allah created us, gave us eyes, ears, nose, hands, legs, provided us with air, clothes, home, neighborhood. He provided us with parents, brothers, sisters, relatives, friends, etc. And He provided us with health and comfort, vegetables and fruits, milk and meat and varieties of food. And He made us humans and, more importantly, Muslims. God forbid, if my kidneys fail and someone donates a kidney, won't I be thankful to Him for all my life? Allah gave us 2 fully working kidneys and so many other things. Each one is so complicated that the whole world can't manufacture one. Means something when you recite it. For example, thank you, Allah, for keeping me alive, keeping me healthy and safe and a Muslim, and that you gave me the chance to pray to you, and so on. Shouldn't my heart be filled with gratitude when I recite this ayah? So habit number 4 is always be grateful to Allah. Remember His trillions and zillions of favors upon you and don't complain for a few missing things which are nothing but a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's it for now. Jazakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.